Hi, welcome to this video. This video's about this TV LED backlight tester. I found another use for it as well. It's fantastic. It's from kasyan TV. All credits go to them. If you like the video, like, subscribe, tell your friends. Let's grow the channel. Cheers. So this is my version of the tester. It's inside one of these little boxes that these terminal boxes, electrical terminal boxes. What have I got? There's an on-off switch. I've got a little LED here. There's the wires to the test clips. I've got a couple of crocodile clips on there. But you could use anything, I suppose. And I've got mine mains powered instead of volt powered, so I'll show you how I've done it. What I've got is a little SMPS power board, which I got, which is 6 volts as it happens, in there. The only things I've done with that is I've put a little heat sink on the voltage regulator there. You can see the heat sink there. And I've also fitted a switch. On off switch straight to the input there, 120 volt, the 240 volt input. Output then comes to my circuit board here, which is the tester, which I'll show you now. Not much to it. I put a little bit of tape on there because it goes in upside down, and I was just wary of creating a short. So obviously there's metal on the end of that capacitor, so I wanted to close that up. And on this transistor, there's metal, so I wanted to close that up. I forget what, oh, I think the coil there as well. There's the 555 timer. That's the little board. Now you could shrink it down and make it smaller onto half the size of this board, I've no doubt, but I just did it that way for some reason. And that fits in nicely. Oh, the other thing I did was the LED on the SMPS, I just took it out and put it into there, so I know I've got, so I can see a visual power supply. That's all really there is to it. You could power it from some batteries, two AA batteries, I think, could do it at 6 volts or whatever. No, they wouldn't do it with the 1.5 or 3. You need 4 batteries in a battery holder of some kind. I found instead of buying batteries, easy to hook it to the mains. It's not kind of a that portable that I need to move it away from the bench. So, yeah. So I'll give you a demo of what it does. Okay. Okay, so welcome back. You wouldn't, but I'm not a professional YouTube blogger like some people, so I don't have the equipment of a professional YouTube blogger. So my camera is my telephone, and it is propped up in the most precarious way, however. Life. So I'm just switching on my tester. These are the leads from it, and you'll see what this thing can do. So this is putting out 120 volts. Where are we? Oh, no. So I should be able to see the voltage there. So I'll just put this on. 124.3. This is only a 1 point, or some. Under 2 volt LED, so in theory it should go pop, right? But no, it lights up lovely. So that's that tested. It's working okay, and you can do this all day long. Probably that one, and probably that's in the center is the ground actually. Doesn't want to grip on, does it? There we are. Okay, so red and green. That's that LED. Here's a strip of LEDs. This is really what it's designed for. So you can find the backlights off TVs and whatever. You can find any bad LEDs. And you can see there, it's lighting them all up, except for the two that are, or three that are dead. Perfect. So you easily found the dead LEDs without having to go on the back and start testing individual points. If you wanted to find the voltage of one of these, you could put a little voltmeter in the tester, which I'm going to do eventually, but I've yet to get hold of a 120 volt voltmeter. I will get one and put it in eventually. So if you want to find the voltage, you can just tap the leads onto multimeter leads and put the voltage across there, and that'll give you the voltage as well. 1.8 volts, there we go. That's that one. And you can do the same with this. This one, that bit more awkward. But do this here. Volts, there we go. 1.7 volts that way. 1.8 volts that way. There we go. If you want to do the string of LEDs, which should be 12 volts across this, because it's a 12 volt strip. 7 volts, there we go. Zener diodes, which I've discovered is a brilliant idea, 3 volts. One of the very few where actually voltage is written on it. Yeah, 3V there. This, what looks like a Zener, is not. It's actually a fast switch. So, that's something I don't know if I can get a close up here, a close ish. What looks like a Zener is not. So, if you're making something and you take out a part that looks like a Zener, it may well not be. That's a fast switch. This as well. I think this is actually a gas tube. That's a Zener. I've got a whole bunch of them here unidentified. So we can find another. No, there's a definite Zener. That blue one, there's a Zener. Let's have a look at this. 28 volt Zener, there we go. So you can go 28 volts now. My homemade power supply only goes up to 22 volts. Impossible to test. Switch the thing off there. So yeah, brilliant thing. Super easy to make. There's a circuit diagram. I'll make a link into Kasyan because it's their circuit diagram. Enjoy. Make it. It's fantastic. Tell your friends, let's grow the channel. Cheers.